making adjustments to proposals that have been made. Because the word pardon sounds a lot of sounds negative.
Yes, definitely. Yeah.
So that process where the agencies have to come with their budgets and all of that to the house and all of that, because of this accusation and counter accusation that is going on, you pardon, you didn't pardon. First of all, let's look at Jibril's position. Why did it have to come up when it seemed like he was asked to leave a particular committee?
Exactly. That's the point, because in the first instance, the budget itself was delayed, very much delayed. Huh? Nothing came out of that process in terms of whether it's been pardoned or not. All of a sudden, it was removed from his office. We said, you're about pardon and not pardon. So I think if you look deeply, maybe we are confusing pardon with the demand of some members for what we call consensus projects, okay? Where they have a right to decide that or not is another issue. But the House has an oversight function. Can add, subtract it. Every agency defends the budget before a committee. And you know your figures, okay? You know your figures. So if at the end of the day, the act or the bill is sent back to the president for assent, the president should call his team and say, look, I've gotten the budget with the details. Is it what you asked for? Why is there a deduction or whatever? And let me say, even when the president assents to a budget is essentially an estimate. It's still an estimate. So, for me, I think we are confusing pardon with an attempt to include projects that are not there for their own benefit. And I don't see why it should be there, because normally members of the House are not contractors. Okay? But you know, over the years, we've been having this issue of consistency projects. There are issues whether any member of the committee of the House or members have tried to corrupt themselves in court through the budget process. So all of these are the issues that I think
481 billion.
Yeah.
Where is this coming from?
See, like I said earlier, you see, when the president presents the budget to the House,
yes,
the House will still go through it.
Of course.
Like you can have, like, say 50 billion naira for defense. And then you have 3 billion naira for education. The House can, within its authority, say, Mr. President, 50 billion naira is too much for defense. We're moving 30 billion naira to education.
Exactly. The House can do that.
That is still very lawful.
Yes.
But the House cannot now, on its own, include a project that is entirely new from what the executive presented. At the stage of preparing the estimates, the members, the senators, they can liaise with the different ministries that,
yes,
come with, I need this project for the benefit of my constituents. Yes. It would have gotten into the budget at that stage.
He's saying that the House
do not have any rights to add new projects.
But you see, in practice over the years,
Prof, because essentially,
yes,
don't forget one thing. The House, it has the power of the purse, then oversight functions.
Exactly.
And then you ask yourself this question. If you have the power of oversight function, and you are the one again inserting projects into the budget as your own project, how do you supervise it? There might be the issue of conflict of interest.
Yes, there's no question.
There.
So the issue is that we have to have an overall of the entire process, because in practice, over time, we've seen the House through this thing called consensus projects, tinkering with the budget. They've been doing that. This time around, maybe it became difficult. They've been doing that. He's right. From a legal point of view and from the constitutional point of view, but in practice, this has been going on wrongly. And so for me, if the budget comes back to the president, okay, each agency or ministry has the right to say, these are not the figures that we submitted, in the sense that it can be reduced. In fact, at times, as you said, the House has the right to even increase. If you argue very well before the committee that you needed more things to be done, you could be surprised. The House has the right to say, okay, instead of giving you X million naira, we'll give it.
I think this is taking even more serious step. This is taking a more serious dimension. Let's look at what the because everybody seemed to be engaging the services of their lawyers. They're warming up
for
a showdown.
Yes.
Now, this is coming from the Jubrin lawyer, the law offices of Mr. Hammat and Cole Law Bound Solicitors and whatever chambers. I read in quote in parts. You will recall that our client is in dispute with the said quartet, talking about the Speaker, Deputy Speaker, House Whip, and House Minority Leader. The quartet, he said, over his refusal and inability to admit into the national budget of 2016 the sum of 30 billion naira at the behest of this quartet, and also his refusal to cover up the decision of the Speaker, Dogger, and others unilaterally decision to distribute to themselves 40 billion. So there's a 30 billion, which they've asked him to do, and they say 40 billion they want to allocate to themselves. Where is the line to be drawn? You think they don't have the powers to be able to include these things in the budget?
Precisely. If they are putting in entirely new projects from the projects that the executive submitted to them, because the budget, as Prof said, is just an estimate of your expenditure and revenue. And the people that can actually know what they are expecting to make will probably be the executive. But mind you, again, Prof said something. He said the issue of constituency projects, that it has been so, that has been the practice in the past. But that does not necessarily make it right and lawful. I'm still maintaining that the core function of a legislator is to make laws and do oversight function, educate his constituents, is not to execute contracts through constituency